Okay, you're live in three.
You'll be dead in live three, too.
Hey, folks, this is Forrest Nash here. I hope you're all safely locked inside. For those of you listening to that last call, you might be wondering what to make of it all. Here's our take. We now believe the killer is actually a woman, one who might manipulate you into letting her in before she attacks you.
What a vixen.
We're neighbors. Look out for each other and stay safe. The killer was calling themselves Dawn.
Dawn of a new day.
This could be a fake name. If anyone needs help or you have info on the killer, please call in. You folks have my new number, right? It's 911. Hopefully, our next caller can help shed some light on our killer.
Hey, we had a call come in.
Okay, folks, time to take a call.
Let's go.
This is Forrest Nash, and you're listening.
Please help me. My name is Casey Moore.
I'm the killer.
25 Nancy Drive. My best friend's been stabbed. He's bleeding everywhere. I don't know what to do. Please help me.
Somebody's been stabbed. Can you tell me what happened?
We've been out at the reservoir. We were heading back to his place when we heard this whistling all of a sudden. He just started freaking out. He screamed at me, told me to hide. I'd never seen him like that, and I just panicked and ran and hid in a bush.
Oh no, Forrest.
Then what happened?
He went up the road and talked to someone. I couldn't really hear or see anything. It sounded like he might have known the person, and they just stabbed him.
Casey, was he talking to a woman?
I don't know.
Casey, you're useless.
They had a mask and wore all black? That's all I know. Please, we need help here.
I'll get you help, but I need to know. Where did the masked person go?
They left. They left him to bleed out. I waited until they were gone, then dragged him into the garage and called 911.
Wait, why didn't she make sure he was dead?
Had to.
Please, he needs to get to the hospital. I can't drive, so we need an ambulance.
We don't have any ambulances.
Forrest, the ambulance was destroyed in the explosion
at
the gas station.
Good job, guys.
You should get all the info you can.
What's your friend's name, Casey?
It's Jason. Jason Parker.
Can you tell us where Jason was stabbed?
They stabbed him in the stomach.
With a spoon.
And they stabbed him again in his leg when he was on the ground, and it's...
We'll be right back. Peggy, patch us through to the hospital.
On it. Phoning St. Gabriel's now. Switch to line two.
Hello, St. Gabriel's Hospital. How can I help you?
Hi, this is Forrest Nash from 189.
Good job doing the voice.
We have a stab victim at 25 Nancy Drive named Jason Parker. He's been stabbed in the stomach and the leg. He's bleeding heavily.
Oh, God, I'm sorry. The ambulance is... Well, you know.
I know what I did.
Please... We need something, or he's going to die.
Forrest, Listen, you're going to have to get him here. We need to see him, and we can't get there ourselves right now.
Let me drive.
We don't have any way to drive him right now. And even if we did, he's bleeding out fast.
All right, listen. We need to buy him time to get here. That means stopping the blood first, and then finding someone to stabilize him. To stabilize him, you really need someone with first aid training. Do either of you have any?
No.
Me neither.
Damn it. I'm really sorry about this, but I have other patients who can't wait. All I can do is talk you through the procedure as quick as I can, and then leave the rest to you. You think you can handle that?
We don't really have much choice. Hit me.
Okay, from the top. If he's bleeding out, then you need to get him comfortable and try to stem the bleeding. Lay him down. Apply continuous pressure directly to the affected areas. When the bleeding slows, get a clean cloth of some kind and hold it over the wounds.
Get them comfortable. Apply pressure. Clean cloths when slow.
Hey,
slowed.
You taking a note to send over here?
Got it, I think.
You said he was stabbed, right? If the object he was stabbed with is still in him, don't take it out. It's stopping the worst of the bleeding right now. If anything, you should secure it so it stays where it is.
I wouldn't have thought of that.
I would, because that's the thing that people tell you.
God, that was a lot of info. But I think we can handle this.
Glad you've got it so far, because there's more to go.
I'm still with you, Doc. What else do we need to know?
If he's lost a lot of blood, he may enter shock.
Put notes on here for me.
If he does, act fast. If you apply a cloth and it's bleeding through, don't remove it. Just apply another on top of it. If it's safe, elevate his legs to get blood circulating to his vital organs. Try to keep him warm. Get him to rest and reassure him. We need the patient to stay calm.
All right. Don't replace bandages. Elevate his legs. Keep him warm and calm. This is a lot.
I'm really sorry. That's as much as I can give you right now. Try to stop the bleeding. Find someone to get him stabilized and get him here as quick as you can. Good luck.
All right, Forrest. Casey's still on line one.
Yep, I was paying attention. Don't worry.
Hello? Forrest, are you there?
Hi, Casey. I'm here. How are you doing?
I need help. I've been putting pressure on his stomach wound since you left. But he's still bleeding. I don't know what to do.
That's good, Casey. The nurse said to do that.
What about the knife in his leg? It's gotta be hell. Should I pull it out?
No.
No, don't touch the knife. The bleeding will get worse if you pull it out.
Are you sure? I'm sorry. I'm gonna stop making suggestions.
Yeah, everyone's a critic.
Don't worry, Casey. We're a team here. We're all going to get Jason through this. Casey, is his leg wound bleeding right now?
I hate looking at that knife. Yeah. It's bleeding. His stomach is worse.
I think we need to secure the knife so it doesn't move around. Do you have anything you can tie around it?
Yeah. There's some laundry piled up on top of the dryer, cloths on the hood of the car, and what else? I guess I've got my jacket.
So it's supposed to be clean. Is the laundry clean or dirty?
Look in the laundry for something like a towel or a shirt. Hold that over the wound.
Okay. Looks like I'm gonna have to buy you some new whites, Jason. Here we go. I'm sorry, Jason. It's secure. I put pressure on his stomach again. I'm starting to think we might make it.
Forrest, can I have a word?
Our new tower is fantastic.
Casey, I'm gonna have a quick word with Peggy. Keep putting that pressure on, and let us know when the bleeding is under control. You're doing great.
But what if something happens?
We'll still be here. Just shout if you need anything, and we'll be there. I promise.
Okay. I'll wait. Jason, please be okay.
Go for Peggy.
What's up, Peggy?
We can't stay on the line with her all night. Dawn is still out there. What if other people need us?
You're right. She's probably on her way to her next target right now.
Exactly. And you heard the nurse. We need someone there with training who can stabilize him. He's got to get to the hospital somehow.
Any suggestions, Peggy?
I might. A little before you started working here, KFAM did a mandatory first aid training course. Me and Karen missed it because we were away on a producer getaway.
You skipped it, didn't you? Never mind. So,
yeah, let's focus on the
first aid course. Help us.
Casey said they're at 25 Nancy Drive, right?
Yeah. Why?
They put up a bunch of cheap houses around there about 10 years ago. So a bunch of people here at the station live around there.
Do you think any of them could help Casey and Jason?
I can call Karen.
Probably.
That
but
jerk.
I don't know who lives there. And since I missed the training day, I don't know who knows first aid.
Could you call them and ask?
I don't know everybody's numbers. I've only ever called Karen. Everybody's personnel info is probably in Reggie's office.
Got it. I'll look through their files in Reggie's office. It's a life or death situation. I'm sure they won't mind.
Right. But there are a couple of problems with that.
Naturally.
It's sensitive information, so Reggie probably locked it in his safe.
Great. Great. Do you have any idea what the combo for the safe could be?
Not a clue. Reggie's a serial note taker, though. Maybe something in his office will give it away. Right.
There's a lot of but ands here.
I'm not gonna like this, am I?
Have you ever heard, the future is floppy?
Peggy, what the hell are you talking about?
I'm talking about floppy disks. Floppy disks are like these futuristic things that have information on them. You put them in a computer and they do something.
Peggy, I know what a floppy disk is.
Anyway, Reggie decided that the future is floppy and started phasing out our physical records and replacing them with these floppy disks. I imagine it's the same for our personnel files.
That's good to know. Since we haven't heard anything from Casey, I'm guessing Jason's okay for now. I'll check out Reggie's office and see what I can find.
You'll need a key for that. I'll just slide it under my door now.
Thanks, Peggy. I just have to look around.
So whenever into knowledge that we're making. It's yeah. Great.
I'll patch my mic down to the office.
Basketball.
So you'll hear
tower.
Me over the intercom.
That's not opening.
We've upgraded the table to dunking on all the good stuff. You know what I'm trying to say. Reggie, where are you? We made enough baskets, that's why we're doing it. Okay, Reggie's not the janitor. Reggie's not coffee man. This looks like the boss man's office. Excellent X-Files poster. Wait, Reginald. Reginald Scott might be the key. Oh wait, he is Reggie. Duh. That's stupid. You insert floppy. So we got tape. Clive, if you're reading this, still stop stealing post-it notes. Dinner at Chupacabra's.
Looks like I need a 4-digit code.
Very important date. Okay, 1982. We're going to try 0829 first. Was there one like 1989? 1982, okay. 1308 and 1982.
This be it.
1107. Deep Cuts Top Secret. The one in the Pizza Killer movie. Excellent. Pause it. He only has one floppy, so we're gonna. Fuck was that? John refused to do the first aid course. He's a war medic. So technically, John might be a good pick. Brad's useless, as we know.
Peggy, I think Reggie's on to you and Karen. Maybe don't bring those
little girl power
into work for a while.
What? She wants her own show. She's been shy about getting involved.
Someone who can help Casey. We already know I can't. Don't waste time.
You're right. I'm sorry. I need to focus on possible candidates. I can read the rest of this later.
So John seems like the best bet so far.
Get a load of this, Peggy. Apparently, I'm a lone wolf type.
He lives on Romero Street. That's funny.
We don't have time for this. We have a man literally.
He's not.
Dying
in, What doesn't integrate with the team?
You're right. I'm sorry.
They paid with
I need to focus
for,
on possible candidates.
They paid
really
Forrest with Peggy.
We're in a hurry.
Seems like we're buds. Karen's really stepped up. She's been mentoring Peggy. They only go be pals when it's convenient to go miss stuff. Barbara gets along great with everyone. She's casting stuff. She lives on Craven Street, so I'll probably live on Horror Street, so I didn't notice. That's pretty funny. Okay, so John. I think John's the only pick. For the sake of the pile, we're taking my personnel disc with us. This is very important. That can stay on the car. The car can stay on the floor. Wait. I thought I got the answer. I thought it was John. How isn't that right? It worked out. I opened the safe. I can't talk to Peggy, so what we miss?
Hey, Peggy, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, come on.
Did you find what we need?
I think I know who our best bet is to help Casey and Jason.
All right, good work. Who should I... Hello? Is anybody there? Please pick up!
Casey, I'm here. What's wrong?
Jason started going pale. I tried to get him to rest, but he just threw up.
He's going in the shock.
Everywhere.